Now, I think the water project is it promises to be one of the first of its kind in the region, and it has never happened before in Malawi, and not just because we have never had a water project, but it's about how we are combining conservation, tourism, and then people management at the same time. Initially, it was supposed to go to the staff that are working in the Wazanyika National Parks, but now it is going to affect, I mean, to benefit over 33,000 people. It's not a small water project.
So what we anticipate is tremendous continued pressure on natural resources. So the more you can enable natural resources to be shared with communities, people around these protected areas, and the more they benefit from it, the more they'll have a vested interest to see it being protected. And I think there's no better example of what we see here in Nyika and Vuaza, where you have a water tower, the Nyika National Park, which we estimate produces about 10% of all the freshwater catchment that goes into Lake Malawi.
In the park, the Plateau Nyika, it's got serious rain every year. But you go down the mountain and you walk, or you drive 10 kilometers, 15 kilometers, and you're in places where communities do not have proper water resources. Either it's salty or it's just not there. And so this water scheme, it's about connecting the plateau to the communities and connecting conservation with the communities.
You know, having one park benefiting people, you know, over 30,000 people is quite unique. But the Tazima Water Scheme project is about channeling one of the rivers and a section of it into a pipeline, and it's a pipeline of about 100 kilometers, and then downstream below the plateau, supporting and helping people to get access to potable water. It's over 116 water points.
So we are very happy that we are here today to witness this that has been made possible because of the funding from the German government through the KfW, but also with the technical support from the Peace Parks Foundation and also from our Department of National Wildlife and National Park. So I think this is what is happening today. So I was receiving the project, but also I think overseeing the commencement of the actual project, and also receiving the perimeter fence of 70 kilometers, which is going to go a long way in terms of preserving the lives of people, because there's been a lot of conflict between the communities, the people, and the wild animals in the national park. So I think because of this fence, we are going to have to reduce the instances of human beings being attacked by animals, I think, significantly. So I'm very, very happy today.
Here in Vuaza, where we stand now, we average about 500 human wildlife conflict incidents per annum. So that's more than one a day. But what's good is that they still have access to the park and to resources such as grass, such as water, such as beekeeping or whatever else. So it's not a, you know, there's gates in it, and the fence is maintained and patrolled by the communities themselves because it's in their interest. It was actually quite a nice project.
Yeah, the reaction of the communities today was absolutely brilliant. Attendance first, there was, I don't know, like probably 1,500, 2,000 people. So I wasn't expecting so many people. And you could tell through the dances, again, the drama. I mean, they were committed, they were involved. It was really people that were the first interested in what was coming. You could feel here that the coming of the water was something, a game changer for these people. And as we all heard, I mean, the first reply we got is, okay, so this is great, but where can we extend the network?
Then women and girls don't get to walk a long distance. So for the girls, they get to be in school instead of spending their time going to look for water. And so they are focusing on their education. The women are focusing on other developmental issues within the home to improve their households, or to generate income for their household. But also, you heard the chief, which is something that I like so much. He said it's also going to contribute in terms of strengthening marriages, because women have to leave their homes at 3 a.m. in the morning and then come back maybe at 9, and when the men have already gone. So in the long run, we are already seeing benefits for the now and the near future. For the next 50 years, we're going to be reaping the benefits of this project. But I think also the administration under the president, Dr. Lazarus, he's talking about issues of job creation, wealth creation, and food security. And this water project, I think, is an embodiment of that, because you can imagine project of this magnitude is also going to employ people. There's going to be a lot of jobs and also multiplier effects from the project itself.
For your information, Malawi is like the warm heart of Africa. People are always happy, they appreciate when you give them something. So it was like more of appreciation to the donors, to our donors, the German government, and also to PPF for fighting for their needs, listening, more of listening to them, what they want. So all those dances, different cultural dances, were actually a celebration to say thank you very much for bringing us this development. The satisfaction is not personal, but I look at the bigger picture to say, okay, fine, here we are, guys, we can do it. So that's the satisfaction that we are able to make an impact to thousands of people and transform their lives.